Good evening, everyone. What a joy to be back in the house of the Lord. We welcome you this Tuesday afternoon back to the Nature Speaks online evangelistic series. We trust you had a good day. We missed you yesterday, but we are delighted that you are there. You are here with us, and we thank God for his blessings, his mercies. So if you are on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, WCCN, or you are in the deaf community, or you are on Bless TV, welcome back. We hope you have been praying, but if you haven't, we still have opportunity to remember 6 a.m., 12 noon, and 6 p.m., and in between. Pray for the evangelist, Pastor Williams. Pray for the entire team. Pray for those individuals with whom you are working, and pray that God will pour his Holy Spirit, that there'll be commitment and recommitment. If you are in St. Elizabeth, Hanover, Westmoreland, or St. James, welcome. If you're in the rest of Jamaica, thank you for joining us. And wherever in the world you are, welcome. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We are going to be looking at God's handkerchief. What could that be? You have to stay connected to find out what that is. And when you found out, whatever the Holy Spirit tells you do, then be sure to do it. So we are going to be praising the Lord. We are going to be giving. We are going to be worshiping in all of these activities. And we are so delighted that you are here with us and you will stay with us for the duration of this program. So won't you join me as we bow our heads in prayer, and then we will turn you over to the praise team. Bow your heads with me as we pray. Our Father, thank you so much for the good day you have given to us, and for those whose day did not turn out quite as expected. We thank you for the grace to have gone through. We commit ourselves again to you. We want to hear from you. Speak to our hearts. And even as we sing now, accept the praise we bring. Bless your people tonight. Bless the ministry of the word. May your name be glorified. Thank you so much for hearing and answering our prayers. For Jesus' sake, amen.
Good evening to all our viewers. We are here once again. We are happy. And I can't see you guys, but I know you are smiling because you're excited for this another evening of our Nature Speaks campaign. Just join us in singing these songs. The first song that we'll sing is Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord. I want to see you. Sing with us.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes. say that I'm your friend.
To hear you say that I'm your friend.
It's your nature.
Won't
Indeed, indeed, indeed. You know, one of the most beautiful things about nature is that nature keeps on giving. If nature reached a point where it stopped giving, well, all of us will be in some serious problems. And so we're just so glad that the heavens declare the goodness of God. And so we're so happy that you have joined us again right here at Nature Speaks, Hope for Tomorrow. And we have reached that point in the program where we will share in being a blessing to somebody else, a blessing to the work. And so you will find right there on your screen the numbers that you can find, and you can give. Give something that will not only give glory to God, but that will be a reflection of nature. I remember the last time I checked that one mango seed that I may have planted, yes? It bore a mango tree that would have given so much. And so I want you to understand that when you give, especially your heart to the Lord, you can be assured that you will be blessed. And so do what you can. And if you perhaps you are near an Adventist church, you can also contact that pastor, that elder, and give right there also. All right, but those of our friends who are online, remember, keep on giving, and may God bless you tremendously as we continue this wonderful work of saving of mankind. Now, I invite you at this time to bow your heads with me as we pray together. Loving Father, we are just so glad that you are still the giver of all things. Loving God, we say thanks that we are blessed and highly favored, that we can be here another evening to be in your presence, to give you praise and honor and glory. We say thanks, Father, that you kept us through challenging times and uncertainties. We're so glad, God, that you provided for us and we can reflect. We say thanks, Lord, for the ways you protected us while we traveled, while we went back and forth. We're so thankful, God, for that unseen danger that you diverted from our direction. We want to praise you, God, that you have sent us this opportunity to be blessed another time. As a Father, we pray now that you will take charge of that which shall be done this evening. We pray, Almighty God, that you'll bless those who have just given and those who are given even now and those who will give. We pray, Almighty God, in a special way for those who this evening have placed those requests in the chats. We pray, oh God, for that prayer request, for that husband, for that son, for that change in that situation. We pray tonight, God, for that person who is seeking salvation for their soul. We pray tonight, God, for that community who just need an injection of peace. We're praying this evening, Father, for that young man who is battling with demon possession. We're praying today, God, for that home that is riddled with confusion. We're praying tonight, Father, for that child who is crying out for deliverance. We are praying tonight, God, that you will wipe away some tear from that eye that has been crying. We pray tonight, God, that you will take charge. And we ask, oh Holy Spirit, that you will move upon your son in a mighty way. Oh gracious God, his tongue can't move unless you direct it. Oh gracious Father, his heart needs your divine power. And so we pray now, oh Holy Spirit, that you will speak to your son another evening. We ask, Almighty God, that you will deliver somebody who is in that den of deception. Somebody, Father, who is just crying out for salvation. Somebody, God, who just need a word of hope and a word of life. We say thanks, God, that you will speak another time. And so we ask you now to take charge of Pastor Donovan Williams. We pray, oh God, that you will even now dispatch from heaven mighty angels to guard your people everywhere. And even that young man who is walking by even now, that young lady who is on her way home from work, oh God, may you arrest their attention with your Holy Spirit's power, and may somebody come to fall in love with Jesus. Is our prayer and our asking in the wonderful name of our Savior. May somebody say amen, amen, and amen.
Hello, everyone. It is now family time. We are happy to have Miss Susan Brown. She's a substance abuse officer for the Parish of St. James. She works at the National Council on Drug Abuse. I invite you at this time to listen attentively to her.
Good evening, everyone. This evening, we're going to be talking a little bit about a very complex and intense topic. We're going to be talking about suicide. But it's very important that before we get started, that persons understand that once an individual is having any kind of suicidal thoughts, they must be taken to the hospital emergency department immediately, where they can be appropriately assessed. This information that I'm going to be sharing with you this afternoon is not treatment, nor should it be used as such. Persons must be assessed by a trained medical health professional, mental health professional, and for any more information, should persons be having a suicidal thought, they can contact 876-952-5100 and ask for the mental health department. Now, as we get started, I think it's critical for us to be able to look at some definitions. So when we're talking about suicide, we're talking about death caused by injuring oneself with the intent to die. Then we're going to look at the whole definition for suicidal ideation, which means thinking about, considering, or planning suicide. And when we look at suicidal attempt, we're looking at a non-fatal, self-directed, potentially injurious behavior with an intent to die as a result of the behavior. An attempt may or may not result in injury. Now, the Jamaican statistics. And this was taken from the Ministry of Health website, Ministry of Health and Wellness website. Before COVID-19, the data tells us that about 1 million people globally die each year due to suicide. Here in Jamaica, the suicide rate is approximately 2.1 per 100,000, with statistics from the Jamaica Constabulary Force reflecting between 47 and 56 deaths per year due to suicide. Now, one of the things that we want to bring to the fore is that suicide can have significant impact on families. It is very important that continuous support be provided and individuals be sensitive to the needs of families. This can be very intense and a very complicated time, and all members of the family can be significantly impacted. There can be feelings of extreme guilt, intense pain and sorrow, sense of helplessness, and research has shown that when there is a suicide in the family, it increases the risk for other members of that family. Now, when we're looking at risk factors for suicide, we're looking again, as I said, it's a very complex concept. There are many reasons why persons, including young people, may have suicidal thoughts. It can be biology, where, for example, there is low hormonal levels, which results in feelings of depression, sadness, you know, suicidal thoughts. It can be as a result of mental illness. For example, a person may be suffering from depression or have like bipolar disorder. There can be history of substance misuse, you know, economic stress, where persons would have lost their job and have no income coming in at all and no means of taking care of family. There can be, as I mentioned earlier, that, you know, when there is suicide in a family, it increases the risk for other family members, research has indicated. Sexual orientation and gender identity struggle. There are times when persons may be struggling with their sexual identity and as a result of such, you know, may have suicidal thoughts. You have persons with a sense of hopelessness, persons who may have been abused sexually and as a result of the abuse may be suffering from feelings of guilt and shame and helplessness and so on. There is also the issue of body image concerns. You know, persons may visit, especially for young people, going on social media, and there's this whole concept of how somebody should look, and it may affect a person's sense of self, and they may end up, you know, having suicidal thoughts. Bullying is another very popular reason why some young people, you know, may have suicidal thoughts. You know, being bullied online, you know, being bullied face to face. You know, these are some serious factors that young people may encounter. We're looking at hospitalization with an infectious disease and worried about infected other family members, peer relationship problems. You know, people overall feeling like they're a burden to others and feel like others will be better off if they were not around. Now, it is important for persons to understand that if a person has any kind of suicidal thought, they need to get professional help immediately for thoughts or attempts. You know, persons need to be encouraged to complete treatment. Encourage persons not to just visit once, but to follow up with their treatment. And to understand that services are available. There are persons who are trained to provide help for persons with suicidal thoughts or previous attempt. We're saying, you know, additional information that persons need to, you know, bear in mind, and not that we're saying that this is treatment, because it certainly isn't, but we want, as parents, guardians, relatives, or friends, to be able to listen to other people, listen to understand, not listen necessarily to agree, but to not be judgmental, to validate other individuals' feelings and help persons to be able to validate those feelings. And how do we do that? You know, we talk about how we are feeling. You know, why am I feeling? Why am I feeling the way that I do? To be able to, you know, identify where in my body am I feeling this, and what do I need right now to help me to feel better? What can I do? It is also important for us to pay attention to our men and boys. Their depression may appear quite different from females, you know, and their mental health is just as important. Keep our children meaningfully engaged. And what do I mean by that? You know, get them involved in voluntary work. Help them to, you know, show others, you know, support and kindness. You know, be able to understand that, you know, by helping others, you know, they are doing something to, you know, lift the spirit of somebody else. Talk about ways to cope with different emotions. When I'm feeling sad, when I'm feeling frustrated, when I'm feeling angry, when I'm feeling depressed, what are strategies that I can use? Teach ways to take care of ourselves. And when we talk about taking care of ourselves, we're looking at, you know, following through on the laws of health. And I know that the conference health department, you know, they're going to be rolling out a program that we can participate in, because healthy body means healthy minds. So just asking persons to be mindful of some of these issues as we look at the whole idea of suicide, suicidal thoughts, suicidal attempt, and suicidal ideation. Thank you so much for listening.
Thank you, Miss Brown, for coming on Family Time. Thank you, viewers and listeners. God bless you. See you next time.
Often falls on my face in sorrow, and as I walked on through the long, lonely night, often I cry when it seems no one hears. Dawning of light. Oh, soon it's all mine, with all of its trials, will be left behind. There's a new day dawning, the shadows of sin.
Amen. Amen. Hold on, my child. Joy comes in the morning, the darkest hour. The day is, morning is just in sight. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our Nature Speaks Hope for Tomorrow evangelistic campaign as we continue to worship and to praise Almighty God. I want to welcome you in a very special way if you are joining us via YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Blessed TV, WCCN, whatever social media platform you're joining us from this evening. We just want to welcome you in a very special way. I know that a number of you probably are in a town square or in somewhere in your community watching. I want to greet those who are in Hopewell Square, or that Hopewell each night carries a program live in the town square. No doubt there are other areas outdoor that continue to carry Nature Speaks. If you are joining us from overseas, it is so wonderful to have you connected with us here at Nature Speaks. And God continues to be tremendously good. We are thankful for those who have surrendered to the Lord in baptism and those who are planning to do so. We want those who are even overseas and you have requested baptism that we will make the connections for you, for this coming Sabbath is going to be a tremendous baptismal service right across West Jamaica Conference, and many from other areas of Jamaica and overseas. We just want to thank God for the tremendous moving of the Holy Spirit on the hearts of individuals. And it is never wrong to do what is right. It is always right to do what is right in the sight of Almighty God. And so I just want to give God thanks for his tremendous blessings, for those who have called to let us know that you are really enjoying Nature Speaks. We are very happy for the impact of the program. Because of the curfew that has been brought forward, we have to just condense our message each evening, and this evening is no exception. I want us to know that we want you to get home and get off the streets before the curfew time. So we just get straight to the word. Our message this evening is entitled God's Handkerchief, and I have mine here, God's Handkerchief. Let's bow our heads as we pray. Heavenly Father, and oh God, we are so happy for the special moving of your Holy Spirit in Nature Speaks. We are thankful, Lord, that you continue to speak to us through nature, the various messages. Help us to trust you and to obey you and to listen to your voice as you guide us. We pray, Lord, for the anointing of your word, the anointing of your servant, and the anointing of every viewer. And may through your spoken word this evening and through the power of the Holy Spirit, you will bring conviction, you will bring conversion, and you will bring transformation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So this evening we look at God's handkerchief. And each evening, each day, We continue to look at something in nature. And we will look at one of the elements of nature, and that is wind. Wind. Wind is the natural movement of air or other gases relative to the planet's surface. And wind can appear or occur on various ranges and scales and range of scales. Wind can appear. There are some wind that are heavy, strong, forceful, and last for a few minutes or for hours. There are some wind that are very soft and can go for days. In our civilization, the concept of wind has been explored in various ways. In mythology, wind has influenced the course of history, the events of history, expanded the range of transportation, of warfare. Wind has been used to provide power source for mechanical work, for electricity, for recreation. Wind has taken individuals to many places. Wind has taken individuals in the air and various parts of the earth. When winds become strong, hear me somebody, when winds become strong, they destroy trees, human beings, human structure. They damage and they destroy. And strong force winds are experienced all over the world. In the United States of America and other parts of the world, strong force winds like tornadoes are experienced. And when once it touches the month of June, we know that that is the beginning of what we call the hurricane season. I think it's from June to November. Hurricane season. And those of us in Jamaica, we are not foreign to strong winds. We are not foreign to hurricane winds. I think before 1988, many of us were not used to hurricanes, but after 1988, Hurricane Gilbert, was it September 12? September 12, 1988. As a matter of fact, some of us did not, I don't want to preach another sermon, but some of us did not even believe that Gilbert was coming. Some of us did not believe the reports from the Met Office, and we went about our own business. But whether we believed it or not, Gilbert came, and Gilbert ravished this country, took lives. Songs were made from Gilbert, but Gilbert taught us several lessons. Revelation chapter 7, and it is a serious message this afternoon, this evening. Revelation 7, I read in your hearing from verse 1. Somebody who is listening, the Bible says, after these things, I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, on the sea, or any tree. Then I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God, and he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees till we have sealed the servants of God in their foreheads. And I say amen. Let me quickly dissect this passage. One, the four angels, four messengers, four of God's anointed messengers, angels, holding back the four winds. They are standing at the four corners of the earth, standing at the four compass poles at the earth, corners, north, east, west, and south. And these angels are holding back, the Bible says, the winds of strife. Now, wind in prophecy symbolizes strife, warfare, calamities, danger. Hear me, somebody. There are four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, and they are holding back calamity, strife. They are holding back the forces of evil. I told you out here that the devil doesn't like a bone in any of God's creatures, any of God's creation. The devil doesn't like a bone in you. The devil wants to see you dead. The devil will set us up, make us feel good and feel all right, and in a blink of a second, the devil will take our lives. The devil is the greatest con man. He's a con man. Make you feel that everything is all right. And when you believe it is peace and safety, then sudden destruction. Hear me, somebody. There are things happening greater than that the eyes can see. The invisible things are more real than the visible things. There is a battle that is going on. There's a warfare that is in place. Christ and Satan, good and evil, and the devil wants you dead. And sometimes we blame God for what he's not guilty of. Where some people will blame God for COVID. God is not the author. God is not the author of sin. The devil is. And as a result of sin, these things are happening, and the devil is out to destroy God's character and God's creation. But hear me, somebody. God is keeping things in control. Weren't it for the protective power of Jehovah God, this world would be a valley of death. But there is a strong force that is fighting against the forces of evil, holding back the winds of strife, holding back calamity, holding back destruction. And by the way, friends, COVID-19 is just a tip of the iceberg. Hear me, somebody. It's just a tip of the evil power of the devil. And if the devil can lock down the whole world, cause the whole world to be suffering. Friends in Hopewell Square, friends across Jamaica, friends across the world, let us open our eyes and see that the devil wants to destroy this world. But God is keeping him at bay. God is holding back the forces of evil. God is keeping things under his control. Weren't it for that? We'll all be in a valley of death. But there are four angels holding back. Don't let the wind blow. Don't let danger come in its fury. Don't let calamity come to the maximum. Why is it then that the devil, why is it that the angels are holding back the winds of strife? Why is it that they are holding the winds of strife? An angel came from the east, having the seal of the living God, cried with a loud voice to the four angels, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the tree. Do not touch the livelihood until God seal his people in the forehead, until God puts a mark on his people, until God identifies his people, until God's people are totally saved. There's a sealing process. God is gathering his people, and nature speaks is here to tell you God is finally gathering his people. There's a gathering going. As a matter of fact, in Psalm 50 and verse 5, I think, Psalm 50 and verse 5, "Gather my saints together to me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice." God is gathering his people. Why? So that there can be one sheep, one shepherd, one fold, one people gathering. And God is doing it through this preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one true God, one true Lord, one true faith, one true fold. And I have no apology for this. One heaven, and there is one way to heaven, and that is through Jesus Christ. And if you love me, somebody need to say amen. Keep my commandments. Gather my saints together. So what he's doing, he's calling back a people to come home. Come back to full obedience. Come back to a covenant relationship. Get back to true obedience to my word. And then he's sealing his people. Please take note that he's sealing them in their forehead. It's a seat of decision. It is a seat of reason, not in their hands, but in their foreheads. Because it's a decision that you have to make. It's an intelligent decision. It is as the Holy Spirit talk to you. It's as the truth of God's word come to your heart. It's as your eyes are open. It's as your minds are open to the truth of God's word. You are going to trust and obey, no matter what it takes. Some of us, to obey God, you have to give up some friends. Some of us, to obey God, you may have to walk away from your job. You may have to walk away from a relationship. You may have to walk away from some things that you love. But your life, your soul's salvation is more meaningful. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and to lose his soul? Nothing should stand between your relationship and God, because when it boils down to gravy, all that matters is your relationship with Jesus Christ. Somebody needs to say amen. It's your relationship with Jesus. Let me hasten on. So they're sealing God's people. I have a few more minutes to go. Sealing God's people. A seal has three components. A seal has the name, the title, and the territory. Joe Biden is his name. President is his title. United States of America is his territory. Seal has three components. What then is a seal of God? What has these three components? What is God calling us to? Why is God holding back? Why is God allowing the angels to hold back? What is he doing? He's calling his people to full obedience. And there is one commandment that has these three components. Exodus chapter 20. We spoke about it on Sunday night. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is what? The Sabbath of the Lord your God. In it you shall do no work, you nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your maid servant, nor your female servant, nor your cattle, nor the stranger which is within your gates. Watch this now. For in 6 days, the Lord, his name, his God, the Lord made, that is his title, his creator. He made heaven and earth, that's his territory, and the sea and all them in is. He is the Lord God. He is creator. And his territory is both heaven and earth. He reigns in heaven and his footstool is earth. He is the mighty God. He is the mighty God. And so, what the call is for each one to return to keeping the commandments of God. But there is one commandment. And church, the Sabbath is not an ordinary thing. I told you on Sunday that if you would you want to get rid of the moon, would you want to get rid of the sun, watch me now. No, because the moon regulates the month. The sun regulates the day. But what about the week? Because we have week, month, we have day, week, month, year. What regulates the week? It is the Sabbath of the Lord. For in 6 days the Lord created the heavens and the earth, and on the seventh day he rested. Close the week. Cannot leave out the Sabbath. But guess what? Oh, Holy Ghost, I have a question to ask you. I have a question to ask you. Can you get rid of the moon? You cannot. Man cannot get rid of the moon because man didn't create the moon. Oh, you know where I'm going now. Can you get rid of the sun even if you want to? You cannot. Man cannot get rid of the sun because man did not create the sun. And I tell you, can you get rid of the Sabbath? No! Because man did not create the Sabbath. God created the Sabbath. Somebody needs to say amen. Before you can get rid of the Sabbath, you have to first get rid of the sun and the moon. And you can't. So why do you think you can get rid of something that you did not create? Man cannot change the Sabbath. God didn't change it. Man cannot change it. The Sabbath stands forever. And God is saying, bring back a people to worship me on my holy Sabbath day. Because when we worship God on his holy Sabbath, we are remembering him as creator. And the devil doesn't want us to do that. And we are remembering him as redeemer. So that's why nature speaks, is saying, come back to the word of God. Come back to the commandments of God. I'm talking to a preacher who knows the truth of God's word. I'm talking to an elder who knows the truth of God's word. I'm talking to you. You know it. You know that the Sabbath is true. Don't put your own satisfaction before the Sabbath. Don't put your own needs before the Sabbath. The Sabbath stands forever. The Sabbath will not save you, but your obedience to the commandments of the Lord, which includes the Sabbath, is saying that you love God. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, honor me. Let me close this message with God's handkerchief. I'm thankful to the Lord that there will always be a remnant who will keep the Sabbath holy, who will stand up for the word of God. And I want to stand up for the word of God. And some people will say, then, Pastor, what about those who worship other than Sabbath? Some are ignorant. And at the time of their ignorance, God will wink. But you are no longer ignorant. You know the truth of God's word. Therefore, stand by the truth of God's word. And then in, let's get back to Revelation chapter 7. As we looked at the whole matter of God's handkerchief, let me bring this message down. And those who are sealed in the forehead, 140 and 4,000. And that is another subject that many people are contradicting themselves with, that many people are just plainly being confused about. But we are not going to go into that tonight, because whether you believe that the 144,000 is literal or symbolic, then that is your conclusion. That does not prevent God's people from making it into the kingdom. Because John said, after these things, I look and behold a great multitude, hallelujah, which no man could number. They come from all nations, from tribes, people, tongues, and they stand before the throne of God and before the Lamb, and I say amen. And they're clothed with white robes. White robes symbolize righteousness. White robe symbolizes the righteousness of Jesus Christ. It is not our righteousness that will save us, because our righteousness is like filthy rags. We are sinners down to the bones. We are sinners down to the core. But praise God, he taketh my old spotted garment, exchange it, he gives me a robe of pure white. But it gets sweeter than that. Oh, stay with me, somebody. The word gets sweeter than that. They are white robes, and they have palm branches in their hands, and palm symbolizes victory. What a day that's going to be, when sin will be no more, when we will stand in the righteousness of Christ. We are going to sing the song of Moses and the Lamb, and we're going to have palm branches in our hands. Let the church say amen. Let somebody say praise the Lord, because one day God's children will be delivered. God's children will be delivered, and crying out with a loud voice, saying, salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb. Salvation is his, because he is the author of salvation. Salvation belongs to our God, because he is the source of our salvation. All the angels stood around the throne. What a place. The elders and the four living creatures fell on their faces before the throne and worship God. What a beautiful sight. 24 elders. And as prophecy tells us, that the 24 elders are redeemed beings from the earth. Four living creatures are heavenly beings. So earth is united with heaven, and we worship God who sits on the throne, because he deserves our worship. He deserves our praise. He deserves our honor. God is God. Saying amen. Blessing, glory, wisdom, thanksgiving, honor, power, might be unto who? Be unto our God, not only one day, but be unto our God forever and ever and ever. Hallelujah! Oh, from one Sabbath to another, from one new moon to another, shall all flesh go up to worship our Heavenly Father. But with 3 minutes to go, it gets sweeter. Oh, thanks be to God. With 3 minutes to go, it gets sweeter. Then one of the elders answered, saying to me, "Who are these?" Hallelujah. "Arrayed in white robes. And whence did they come?" Whence cometh they? Where they come from? And I said to him, "Sir, you know." So he said unto me, oh hallelujah, "These are they who have come out of great tribulation." Are you hearing me, church? These are they who have gone through COVID-19. These are they who have gone through persecution and trials and difficulties and hunger. These are they who have gone through great tribulation and have washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb, and have made them white in the blood of the Lamb. These are they who stood up for the commandments of the Lord. These are they who had the courage to obey the commandments of the Lord. These are they who have the courage to obey the Sabbath and to keep it holy. Stop going to market on Sabbath and to worship God. These are they who wash their robes white in the blood of the Lamb. But it gets sweeter with my 2 minutes to go. Therefore, they are before the throne of God, and they serve him day and night in his temple. What a beauty that's going to be. Day and night we shall worship, and he who sits on the throne will dwell with them. Somebody needs to say amen, because God will dwell with us forever. We shall live with God. Hey, never had the privilege of spending a night in King's house or Jamaica house. Never had the privilege of going to the White House. Went to Buckingham Palace a few times. Saw the Queen wave in her hand, royal wave to her people. I waved back, thought it was me she was waving at, but never remember that there were thousands of individuals there. I waved back, but I've never spent a night in Buckingham Palace. Never spent a night in the White House. But praise be to God, one day I shall live with my Savior. I shall live with my God forever and ever. I shall live with God forever. And God shall dwell with his people. But even though my time is up, I have to read this. Hallelujah. This is the hallelujah part of it. God shall dwell with us and shall lead us. Neither they shall neither hunger anymore nor thirst anymore. The sun shall not strike them no more. Somebody needs to say amen. Hey, there is no politician. There is no politician, no matter how powerful he is. There is no politician. There is no doctor who can tell you you will never hunger again and you will never sick again. But my God has uttered that one day we shall hunger no more. One day, no more sickness, no more COVID-19, no more cancer, no more pain, no more sorrow. Leave me, let me praise my God, because better days are coming. Better days are coming, but I have to close. God's handkerchief. For the Lamb who is in the midst of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to the living fountains of water. And God, hallelujah, God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. God's handkerchief. God shall use his handkerchief of righteousness and wipe away all tears from our eyes. Somebody who's thinking of suicide, one day crying will be over. One day suicide will be over. Somebody who's going through trials and difficulties must know weeping will only endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So God understands your tears. God understands your weeping. Sometimes nobody knows the trouble we are facing. Sometimes only our pillars know the tears. Sometimes even strong men have to cry. Sometimes not only just women, but strong men have to cry. But one day, wish I had time to shout hallelujah. One day, God shall use his handkerchief of righteousness and wipe away all tears from our eyes. But before we get to that experience, we have to stand in obedience to God's word. God is sealing his people. God is not just sealing Seventh-day Adventists, but God is sealing all those who are obedient to his word, obedient to his commandments, obedient to his truth, obedient to his Sabbath. All that he's asking you now, young man, stand up and trust and obey him. Young lady, stand up. Put your soul's salvation first. Put God first in your life. Stand up for Jesus Christ. God is calling you now. Make that commitment. Walk away from sin, because all that sin has to give us is shame and disgrace. Sin will put us on a high and drop us on a low. But tonight, Jesus is calling for full surrender. Will you do so now? If you are online, go to our website. Go to that decision card. You will see it pop up there. Make a decision for Jesus. If you are in the United States, if you are in England, if you are in Canada, wherever across the world you are, Australia, but you have heard the truth of God's word, make a stand tonight for Jesus Christ. Thank God for the many who have decided, and yes, I will make that call that I have to make to that friend overseas who wants to be baptized. I make that call. You can make your decision for Jesus Christ right now. If you're in St. Elizabeth, if you are in St. James, Hanover, Westmoreland, wherever across Jamaica you are, if you have been worshiping otherwise on the Sabbath, you can make your decision for Jesus. If you need to come home and be sealed, because the sealing is going on, and one day, the angels are going to let go, and it's only those who are sealed by the seal of the living God will be saved. Make your decision now as a song is rendered, the promised land. Make your decision for Jesus tonight as nature spoke to you. that will be. Sing this song. Holy Spirit is moving on the hearts of God's people. Somebody is making that decision. And parents, if your children have decided to stand up for Jesus, encourage them. Lead them to Jesus. May God seal them as He's sealing adults. Will you come to Him now? Make a decision for Jesus. It's a glorious day. It's gonna be. Closing moments, closing moments.
No sorrow there.
Closing moments. You are struggling.
No more sickness.
But the struggle can be over now. Because Jesus wants to give you that breakthrough. Jesus wants to give you that deliverance. Want to break the power of sin. Want to break the chain that is binding you. Give Him a chance. Make a stand for Him. Walk to the altar. Walk to the front of the worship. Talk to a pastor. Talk to a leader. Talk to a church member. Get online. Make your decision for Jesus. Seal it now. Be a part of the group that has been sealed by God. Let the Holy Spirit gather you into one fold. Because there is one sheep. There is one shepherd. There is one fold. Let God do it for you. We are closing now. By the hand. Promised land. What a day. Glorious day. Our heads are bowed, our eyes are closed. Our Father God in heaven, we're happy this evening that you're sealing your people. From all corners of the earth, you're sealing your people. You're sealing your people online through social media. You're sealing your people. They're standing in a church. They're sitting at their homes. They're standing in a square. They have heard your call. And they want to be sealed with the seal of the living God. Father, we pray that wherever your people are, right now, move upon each heart. Move upon each mind and let there be a total surrender of life to you this evening. Breakthrough for somebody. Give deliverance to your people. And come this Sabbath when the water is troubled, may many stand in total surrender to you. Walk into the watery grave of baptism and demonstrate their love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Whether your tears are many or few, God wants to wipe your tears, my tears. I trust that as the Holy Spirit spoke to your heart, you heeded His voice. Let there be such a rejoicing this Sabbath as we commit and recommit to God, His handkerchief stands ready to wipe our tears. Thank you so much for watching, for listening. We look forward again to being here tomorrow evening when again we'll worship God. Till then, we say to you, stay connected. Remember, share the link, invite a friend, and remember, pray 6 a.m., 12 noon, and 6 p.m. The Lord bless you. On behalf of the production team, we say thank you. God bless. Stay connected.